Second newsmaker today, NBA sensation. More seriously, Kobe Bryant landed a few hours ago in Dubai, 2 days ahead of his coaching stint on Friday. Very excited. Reporter colleague of ours, Zina Zalameh, was at the press conference where a major announcement was made.
An hour after landing in Dubai, Kobe Bryant's already been given a DMCC trade license by no less than Ahmed bin Sulayem himself, chairman of the Free Trade Zone. But the LA Lakers superstar will have to worry about setting up a business in Dubai another time. His first ever visit to the Emirate will be all about living an active lifestyle. Is he here to convert the Emirates football fans into basketball fanatics?
The sport itself is such a great sport that hopefully it'll transition over. But it's a process though. You know, so you want to talk about getting better, it takes time. You know, it takes camps, you know, clinics, you know, just teaching the basics and the fundamentals of the sport. I don't think we'll ever be able to take down football, and I don't think that's a realistic goal at all, but you want to be able to increase the popularity of the sport of basketball, and hopefully we can do that.
His immediate priority, in fact, is to raise awareness about the prevalence of diabetes in the UAE and the rest of the region, and he's doing that by coaching a celebrity basketball team made up of the who's who of Dubai. They'll be up against Real Madrid players on Friday. At a press conference just moments ago, Kobe shared that a few of his relatives suffered from diabetes, and he himself is trying to live a healthier lifestyle to avoid developing it and other potential diseases in the future.
Coming up, it was very easy for me to just eat whatever I wanted. Metabolism was so quick, I didn't feel it affecting my performance at all. The hardest part about getting older, you play in the NBA, is not the training. Because you're so used to training, you know, for so many years. The hardest part is being able to change your diet. You've been accustomed to eating crap food your entire life. Now you have to have a determination, inner struggle with yourself to put that stuff to the side and actually start eating healthy again. I made the change probably about 3 years ago, 3.5 years ago, where I started becoming insanely competitive with what I'm eating. And eating for performance and eating for recovery and eating with a purpose.
He may not transform the UAE into a basketball-loving nation, but he's keen on inspiring many young people here to be more active.
Hopefully I can help kind of show them how to be active and, you know, how fun it is to be active, whether it's playing a sport by yourself or playing with your friends. I mean, there's so many things that can be done, but it can't feel like it's a chore. You know what I mean? You want to go out there and you want to have a good time. You want to play. You want to have fun with your friends. And by the process of doing that, you're being active and being more healthy.
This is Zina Zalameh reporting for ARN News.